So
you.
there are a lot of children. I also see there are many children who aim like to join the armed forces. What would your advice be to those children as a senior or maybe senior or a member who was a part of the armed forces?
See, my advice is the thing is that whatever you want to do in life, you want to join the armed forces, you want to go into corporate, you want to be an entrepreneur, whatever you want to do in life, firstly, it has to align with your passion. Don't do something just because someone else is telling you to do, right? If you're really driven, if you know, if that's that fire within you and that fire starts and you got that clarity, there's nothing better if you can get clarity as a child of what you want to do in life, because then you're so focused and you just concentrate there. But there are some kids that are not able to figure it out very early in life. They take time to figure out. That's also fine. But as long as whatever you want to do in life is aligned with what you really want to do in life, is what all matters, right? So if you want to be, if you're driven to serve the country actively, because I believe everyone serves the country, whether it's a civilian or an armed forces, you serve the country in your own way, right? You serve the country being honest, being true to your work. If you are a non-armed forces person, in armed forces, yes, you get an opportunity to serve directly. So my point is that if you are driven to serve the country, being in direct touch, being that charm of being in uniform, living a life of discipline that starts, you know, physical discipline, because everyone is disciplined. They need to be disciplined. But your discipline is something which is a very important ingredient of the armed forces and which is so visible, right? So if you want to be a part of that, you want to command men under you who are ready to give their lives on one command that you give, and you've got to prove yourself as a leader there. You want to do flying, military aircraft, or fighters, or whatever. If that's your passion, then this is a great place to be in, believe you me, because it will give you so many opportunities to do not just what you're doing, but a lot more beyond that. You want to be a skydiver, you want to get into adventure sports, you want to do, you know, you want to serve with other armed forces. All those opportunities are given here. So it's a great place to be in. You are taken care of, you feel like a part of the family, you feel belong to you actually, they make you feel belong to that place, because that's how the organization work. There has to be so much of synergy there. There has to be so much of
Yes.
coherence and alignment. So if you are driven, if those are those values, so the first thing that comes back is you need to figure out what are your values. Even as a child, right? If my value is to serve the country, to have a lot of integrity, so probably my interest lies there and I should go in there. Okay, so figure out what are your values, choose a career which is aligned with it. And if you're choosing armed forces because your values are there, your interest is there, I think just go for it. I would strongly advise you to go for it without any second thoughts. But
Yes,
don't do it
ma'am.
just because someone else is telling you to do it. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. And many children or something, many children also face a lot of challenges regarding the family aspect of things, because yeah, it is not easy, at least in this country, to decide and like just go for it. You have to take, there are many external factors that affect your choice. Ma'am, what did you face a problem like this? And if you did, any advice for our young viewers, and so that they can join military or navy, any armed forces, for as a matter of fact.
Oh, okay, Aditya. So while growing up, I did not have any kind of pressures from my parents. That was, I think, a huge plus. So they just left it to us, do what you want to do. And that is the reason we could take such a, you know, big decision, and we could do things that we wanted to do at that point in time. But I understand there is a lot of pressure from a lot of people, because, and especially why it comes from parents is because if a parent wanted to do something in life which they've not been able to do, you know, their ambitions which like unfulfilled, They want their kids to fulfill those ambitions. And I think mostly the pressure comes from that side, that I wanted to be so and so, I couldn't be, so please you be, or you better be, or you should be, kind of thing. So I think it's more for the parents to, if they are listening to me, to realize that just let your child be, because you know, you guys are amazing. I see this generation, your generation, Aditya, the amount of clarity you have, the amount of, you know, imagine you doing such a thing. You're just so young, you know, doing these interviews with me. Never thought of in our age. I mean, we were so naive. We did not have so much knowledge that was available, so much of wisdom that was available at the click of a button. You have that with you. So make the most of it constructively. You know, this can also go in a different area. It can be destructive in a lot of ways. So just be focused on what you want. And probably your parents, I'm sure, will understand when they know you are so driven to do something in life. I'm sure these days parents are also very flexible, understanding, right? And for them, the child's happiness matters most. And if it doesn't, it should. So that's my message to the parents. But to the kids, my message is that stay focused. And if you are able to figure out what you want in life, just go for it.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you for sharing that. And it is very, many people should join or volunteer for armed forces, because it gives an experience and it also gives an opportunity to impact the country at your own level. So thank you, ma'am, for sharing that. And many children, I know as a matter of fact, many children want to join Navy and have a sense of patriotism to our country. So I think they will be really impacted by your answer. So ma'am, please tell us about a few advice for girls. Not like generally all children, but girls in India who want to open their wings and fly and try and want to like go into this field. How can we do this?
See, Aditya, before going to that, you need to understand, everyone, including parents, they need to understand, let's not box them, right, with what the society expects them to behave like, what the society expects them to act like. Because what research says that all your belief systems are formed at a very, very early stage. They start to form as and when you are a child, and they are the ones that dictate your actions and behaviors and your results later in life. And a lot of them are formed during the foundation period, is your childhood. So I think it's the duty of the parents to make their child, especially if they have girls, as confident as they can be, because that is a huge gap we see when women are out there. What is it that is stopping them is the confidence level they have compared to their men counterpart. And a lot of that starts with the upbringing part of it, right? So as a girl, just be very confident of who you are. Just embrace yourself the way you are and understand that, you know, don't get into this kind of a comparative as and when, because there are different stages of growth, have different challenges. So once you come into that adolescence, teenager, you want to look beautiful and that's all fine. But in case, you know, you just need to embrace the way you are, who you are. That's what is more important, rather than just going after the way you physically look. You need to spend some time with who you are from within. And do something to enrich yourself, do something to engage yourself with so much of knowledge and wisdom which will not be taught you in the school level, right? So have mentors, have people who inspire you, learn from them. What is it that they do differently that you do? So if you're inspired ever since you are growing up, you will have, you know, a reason, you will have a motive to work towards that, and nothing can impact your self-confidence. So as a girl, I just want to tell you, you are no different than boys are. You are as good as boys are in every possible manner. And there's no research which says that you aren't, right? So do not belittle yourself. Do not underestimate the power that you have. And just go ahead, have that drive and that passion to be someone, to do something in life, and to create an impact and influence, which is much bigger, and which later can make this world a better place. So let's all contribute together, and you are a very, very important part of this system, right? So just embrace that, be just true to yourself, be the whole of who you are, and just love yourself unconditionally. So that will give you the power to do what you want to do in life.
Yes, ma'am. Absolutely. What you said was really, really, it is very important for all children, not only girls, to understand that they have to focus on, like, if you see, there are many children who are doing TikTok and all of these things. They have to focus on internal well-being rather than external well-being. You should focus on all these things, and ultimately you will get better from all the aspects and angles, and you will become the best possible person you want to be. So ma'am, thank you for sharing that, and it is really interesting to learn like all this from you, ma'am. So thank you for sharing that. So ma'am, please tell, so your major work, your general work which you now do, impacting all these women and all girls around our nation, I heard your theme, like I will say, the successful women bring world-class and holistic success education to enable and empower women to create the life and lifestyle they truly desire. Please advise more about this mission. You talked about it before, and how do you impact like all the women around you?
Okay, thank you, Aditya, for asking that question. Well, you know, the successful woman, the TSW as we call it, was basically born out of passion. So I'm the chief ambassador of that initiative, and my co-chief ambassador is Joanna James, who's from Australia. So both of us got together, and the founder is Ron Malhotra, who is one of the best mentors in the world. So under him, we got together and we brought, we started this movement. And why we did that was, we have worked predominantly in both of us in male-dominated domains throughout our lives. And we totally get and understand what a woman has to go through. You know, she goes through various stages of her life, or what challenges is she facing in each stage, and what requires for her to overcome those challenges. We've just understood it so well from our own experiences. And basically what we want women is to increase their confidence and competence so that they can follow their passion and live a life of success and impact, right? And a lot of women are stuck in various stages of their life, like I said earlier. But this platform is basically based on integrated experience of more than 40 years, some deep research, and the biggest insights and tools that we have learned from our own life, our life experiences, and from our amazing mentors that we have today. So, and like I said, the passion to serve women comes from our own experiences that we've been through. So we realized, why are so many women who are stuck? We need to be pushed forward so that they can reach their full potential. And that is the endeavor, that is the effort that we are making here. Another thing we understood, Aditya, was that, you know, our traditional education system, it does not prepare you. It just prepares you for a career. It doesn't prepare you how to excel in that career. It doesn't prepare you how to go in for higher leadership roles. It doesn't prepare you how to determine the quality of your life experiences, the quality of your health, mindset, well-being, career, relationships, and so on and so forth. So there is a gap there. And this gap is felt when you come across challenges in life and you do not understand how do we owe. So a lot of women give up, right? They have all the talent, they have all the passion, but due to different circumstances and situations, they give up. So we are the ones who are pushing those women to reach to their higher potential and to reach their definition of success, whatever it is, right? It could be a lady who loves to work at home. She wants to get into a business of baking. It could be a lady who is stuck at middle level management. She wants to reach the CEO position, right? So we help women who are driven by that fire, but they're stuck because of various reasons. And so that's what we do. And we realize that we are all born to do amazing things in life. But 90% of us, we get just stuck into mediocrity, which should be absolutely unacceptable, right?
Yes,
so this is the, you know, giving you a little gist of who we are and what we do and where is your passion.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, coincidentally, your purpose, which you stated, I'll just summarize it, is like you want to bridge the gap between knowledge and success, right? You want to do that. And coincidentally, that is the main idea which I started this channel with. And not at that later level of life, like when people realize that they are already in such a big mess. I want to help children, like from the starting, just cut the root of the problem. So all these interviews I do are just basically so that people can share all those qualities and values which are not required to achieve and excel in life. If I give an example, if someone is good at maths and is like a person with extraordinary abilities and talents in maths, but does not know how to communicate, then he will not get that far in life. And if a person knows how to communicate well and does not know anything else, he can get a lot. Like there was a person called Dale Carnegie, and he was a very interesting person, and he was like this only, and he did a lot in his life by just like making the right use of all these qualities. So yes, ma'am, thank you for sharing that. And
again, congratulations for doing what I just want to congratulate. For doing what you are doing. And I think you've started at such a young age, and this way to go for you, Aditya. I see a huge future where you're already impacting so many lives and inspiring them to become a better version of themselves. So congratulations, and just keep going. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you. And ma'am, what mistakes as per you, like we do in families, society, like which shatter the dreams like of a young girl and like to do good things in their life. How does family affect girls and what do you think families should ideally be in order to support and nurture a child to become the successful version of themselves?
Yeah, that's a great question, Aditya. What is happening is that when it comes to girl child, they're like stereotyped, right? There's a list of do's and don'ts for them. You got to behave in this manner. You got to look in this manner. You got to speak in this manner. What happens is that while growing up, you're growing up with these preconceived notions of what you have been told by others and not what you want. Right. So in a later stage of life, our decisions are made based on what others want and not what you want. So what happens is most of us end up, you know, doing jobs in relationships that do not give us happiness and fulfillment. And after a certain point in time, because our decisions are based on something else, on what people say, on what family says, on what society says, these decisions are not based on what we want. Is that we go wrong in life. And that is where people start to come, you know, in the downward spiral that we call at TSW, where there is lack of fulfillment, that there's lack of enthusiasm, there is lack of drive. So all these things happen. And it starts from your childhood, because to the parents, my advice is do not box your kids, whether it's a male child or a female child, into what your conventions, what your notions are, right? Just give them that freedom to be. And while growing up, kids will not do what parents will tell them to do. Kids will do what they see their parents doing. So you got to be the role model of your child. If you want your child not to be on the social media, you have to make an effort of you not being on social media all the time. Because the child sees you doing that, he feels that's the right thing. It's a normal thing to do, right? So you need to make some, I know life is very demanding these days. There's so many work pressures and everything for parents. But whatever time you take out, no matter how minuscule it is, with your child needs to be that quality time when you're there with your child 100%. And, you know, you should do things you want your child to do. Because I've seen families where the parents are very rude to their parents. And the child sees them doing that. And he feels that's normal. So tomorrow the child is rude to his parents. So you need to, you know, keep that in mind, that your child is watching you all the time, even if you do not realize it. And it's just trying to imbibe you. So if that's a huge one message I have for the parents. If you want the child to be something, you've got to be that first, right? It starts from you. You are the first guru of your own child. And then the child goes out to the school and does learning from outside. So give him or her the best environment. Give him or her the best emotional confidence to be their best, to do their best. You know, teach them to take risks. Teach them that it's okay. It's okay to make mistakes, but learn from the mistakes, right? Wi-Fi. Yes, so these are, teach them the life lessons that nobody is going to teach them. Rather than them making mistakes and learning later, teach them those lessons right away as they are growing up. So that's my message to the parents. And that is a great question, Aditya. Thank you so much for asking.
Yes, ma'am. Well, that is very interesting. So just summarizing for my viewers, ma'am said that don't make decisions for your children, but make your children worthy of making their own decisions. So that is what ma'am said, and thank you for sharing that. It is a very interesting thing, and I will note this down for sure. So ma'am, please advise like some book which have made the maximum impact in your life and which you would suggest to our viewers.
Yes, there are a lot of them, Aditya, but the first book that made a huge impact in my life was Jonathan Livingstone's Seagull. And after reading this book, I developed the passion for flying. And I wanted to become like that seagull, which was just not, you know, held back by any of the self-limiting beliefs that were there. So this had a huge impact. And I don't know how many times I read that and reread that book. The next one I remember was called The Alchemist by Paulo Coelho. And this was another inspirational book for me. But what changed my perspective totally in life was the book called The New Earth by Eckhart Tolle. And this made me realize there's so much in life which I don't know. And I need to start seeking that. And that is where my journey of self-development, self-discovery, of enhancing myself, becoming better version, and all that started. So that was a book which had a huge impact. There are a couple of other books which should give me any huge management lessons, like The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People by Stephen Covey. Because he gives you some framework, some principles which are so useful. If you use them in your daily lives, they are very, very effective. Then there's another book called The Secret, which made me understand how to use law of attraction to attract all the abundance and the good things in life. And why is it that important? There's another book called Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill, which also is very inspirational. So there've been a lot of them, but I think these are the top most in my list. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you for sharing that. And any role models so you have done a lot in your life. We already learned that for my viewers for watching till now. Ma'am, you heard the full story of ma'am, and ma'am has done so much in her life. And that couldn't have been done without some inspiration of some sort. Ma'am, who are the people who inspire you? And have inspired you the most?
So there have been lots of them, Aditya. They've been like in my family, I've seen my mother. I've learned unconditional love, compassion from her. I've seen my father. I've learned determination, willpower, not giving up, go-getter attitude from him. Then I had my teachers in school who taught me some of the greatest life lessons. So they were my role models during that period. And later I had some of my colleagues who I looked up to and wanted to become like them as a professional. But overall, if you see, my mentors, I still have. And I look up to them and I want to become like them because they inspire me every single day to become a better version of myself. So they're there. But if you see globally, someone who everyone knows, I think Oprah Winfrey is one person who really inspires me. Because if you see the background that she comes from, the struggles that she went through and what she's now, and she's making a huge impact. She started with, she actually brought up this new concept of talk shows, right? She caused a huge revolution there. So she's been a pathbreaker. She's been a trailblazer for a lot of them. Another person who inspires me, if I see history, is Albert Einstein, right? Because he was considered as a loser for a very long time. The schools kind of expelled him. The college did not take him, but he never gave up. And what I've learned from is that in spite of all the repeated failures he've had in life, he taught us the view of never giving up, to getting up, good, doing actions and making something worthwhile out of your life. And and he did so much in physics, which just changed the way we see life today. Is a lot of contribution goes to him. And also he had an angle, a philosophical angle to whatever he was doing. So if you see his life history, the life lessons, there are a lot of life lessons we will learn from him. So he does inspire me big time. And I just love his quotes. So this is what it is, Aditya. And I kind of try and get my inspiration from every person I come across. So today, even from you, I'm going to learn a few things for sure.
Yes, ma'am. I don't know about you, but I learned a lot today, ma'am. And thank you for sharing all of the wonderful knowledge and wonderful experience. And it was really interesting to interview you, and it's a once in a lifetime opportunity for me, ma'am. I also want to learn. Please advise two people whom you would like to see and learn from on this show.
Okay, so one could be my co-ambassador, Joanna James. She's an amazing person again. It'll be lovely to have her. I will probably share her contacts. And then is my mentor, Ron Malhotra. Oh my God, he is out of the world. So these are the two people I can recommend, and they can be on your show. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you for sharing those. And any advice? So ma'am, thank you for coming on the show. And lastly, ma'am, any advice for me and anything you liked about my channel, Aditya Talks, and any advice from for me from the perspective of my viewers?
Yes, Aditya, I am just so happy to see kids like you who are driven by, a cause. You have a cause, and you've realized that at such a young age that how important it is to keep kids motivated, to give them that focus. And I think you're doing a great job. I'm really inspired to see you, to see the energy that you have, the level of understanding and maturity that you have developed. So just keep going, Aditya. You're doing a wonderful job. And I wait for you to grow up and see how you grow up and what you grow up into. So I'm very, very, I would wait for that day, and probably we will have an interview again. When you grow up, probably I'll be taking your interview at that point in time, and wishing you all the best. Keep your energy level high. Keep this focus going, and I wish you all the best in all your future endeavors, Aditya. It's very important. See, it's not just what the journey is not about what we want. It's a journey of who we become in this process of what we want in life. And during this journey, if you are able to add value to others' lives, I think there can be nothing better than this. And you having realized it at such a young age makes me so happy. It probably gives me hope that the world is heading in the right direction if we have more kids like you.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you for coming on the show. And my viewers, I hope you learned a lot today. I certainly did, and there's no doubt about it. And if you have any ideas or any doubts, please share those in the comments below. And thank you, ma'am. for coming on the show. Please like, subscribe and share so that many more people can learn. And thank you, ma'am, for coming on the show. And I hope I will
thank you, Rishi. Pleasure was mine.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.